मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई फाउंड दैट सम ऑफ यू गाइज हैव डाउट इन जर्नल एंट्री. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डू अनदर क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम जर्नल एंट्री. दिस इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 20 फ्रॉम योर टेक्स्ट बुक. सो वी विल स्टार्ट जर्नल एंट्री विद स्टार्टिंग विद बिजनेस ओपनिंग एंट्री. सो फर्स्ट एंट्री फॉर स्टार्टिंग अ बिजनेस विल बी स्टार्टिंग बिजनेस विद कैश 50,000. सो ओनर बोट कैश 50,000 इन द बिजनेस. वॉट बिजनेस विल रिसीव? बिजनेस विल रिसीव कैश. सो वी विल डेबिट कैश अकाउंट बाई 50,000 एंड वी विल क्रेडिट ओनर अकाउंट बाई 50,000. बिकॉज वी डू नॉट मैंशन द नेम ऑफ द ओनर इन द स्टार्टिंग कमेंसमेंट ऑफ बिजनेस. सो वॉट वी विल डू, वी विल मैंशन द कैपिटल अकाउंट एज वी आर स्टार्टिंग अवर बिजनेस. नेक्स्ट एंट्री इज ओपनिंग अ करंट अकाउंट बाई अ पर्सनल चेक. अगेन ओनर बोट कैश फॉर 3,50,000 इन द फर्म, बट दिस टाइम ही बोट थ्रू द बैंक बिकॉज ही इज ओपनिंग अ करंट अकाउंट. सो द एंट्री विल बी बैंक अकाउंट डेबिट टू कैपिटल अकाउंट. अमाउंट विल बी 3,50,000 एंड 3,50,000. ओके, सो नेक्स्ट एंट्री इज परचेज मशीनरी अगेंस्ट चेक. सो बिजनेस गॉट मशीनरी बिकॉज वी परचेज, वॉट एवर वी परचेज वी विल डेबिट इट, बट वी हैव नेम ऑफ द थिंग दैट वी परचेज बिकॉज वी परचेज मशीनरी. सो वी विल डेबिट मशीनरी बिकॉज बिजनेस गॉट मशीनरी. सो वी विल डेबिट मशीनरी अकाउंट डेबिट, बट बिजनेस डू नॉट पेड कैश फॉर दैट मशीनरी. वॉट ही पेड? ही पेड चेक. So, for paying check, it will credit to bank account for 1,00,000. In the same entry, if we don't have the name of the thing we are purchasing, we will use purchase instead of machinery. And if we don't have paid check for that, we will use cash, or maybe if we purchase it on basis of credit, we will use name of that person because we don't have name. So if in case of credit purchase, we don't have name, we use vendor to vendor account if we don't have name of the vendor. Next entry is paid wages for machinery installation. Basically, entry for wages will be wages account debit to cash. But here we are paying wages for machinery installation. So it will add to the cost of the machinery. So instead of debiting wages account, we will debit machinery account. Machinery account debit to cash account. Of how much amount? 2,000. This is new thing that in case of purchase of machinery, we will debit machinery. In case of installation of machinery, we also debit machinery account because it added to the cost of the machinery. Okay. Our next entry is purchase timber from Singh and Company, Ludhiana, Punjab at a listed price of 20,000 less 10% trade discount. So we purchased goods. Purchase account debit 18,000. From whom? Singh and Company. To Singh and Company 18,000 because we purchased goods for 20,000, but they allowed a 10% trade discount to us. As we studied, that trade discount we deduct directly from the amount. We don't have to mention it here, discount allowed or discount received, anything. For trade discount, we will directly deduct it from the value of the sale or purchase. So in case of purchase, we purchased good of 20,000, but we received a 10% trade discount. We will deduct it directly and the purchase value will be 18,000 because we are purchasing goods from Singh and Company. So we will take purchase account debit to Singh and Company because they did not mention anything that we are purchasing in cash or by bank. So it is an credit transaction. So we will use the name of the firm from where we are purchasing the goods. Our next entry is out of the above timber used for furnishing the office. सो वी परचेज्ड टिम्बर फॉर 18,000, आउट ऑफ विच वी यूज 5,000 फॉर फर्निशिंग द ऑफिस. सो वॉट वी डिड, वी मेड फर्नीचर फॉर ऑफिस. सो बिजनेस विल गो फर्नीचर अकाउंट डेबिट टू बिजनेस. डू नॉट पेड कैश और बैंक फॉर दैट, बिकॉज वॉट दे डिड, दे यूज दैट टिम्बर दैट दे परचेज फ्रॉम अनदर सेलर. सो दे आर यूजिंग देयर ओन गुड्स. सो इट मीन्स वी आर रिड्यूसिंग आवर परचेजेस. वी विल क्रेडिट परचेज अकाउंट इंस्टेड ऑफ कैश और बैंक अकाउंट, बिकॉज वी फॉर फर्निशिंग द ऑफिस वी आर नॉट परचेज एनीथिंग फ्रॉम आउटसाइड, वी यूज आवर ओन गुड्स फ्रॉम ऑफिस. नेक्स्ट एंट्री इज सोल्ड टिम्बर टू राकेश ऑन लिस्टेड प्राइस ऑफ 10,000 एंड अलाउड हिम 10% ट्रेड डिस्काउंट. एंट्री फॉर दिस विल बी वी सोल्ड गुड्स टू राकेश. इट मीन्स वी आर सेलिंग गुड्स टू सेल अकाउंट. हियर वी आर नॉट रिसीविंग एनी मनी फ्रॉम राकेश इन द फॉर्म ऑफ कैश और बैंक. सो इट मीन्स इट्स एन क्रेडिट ट्रांजेक्शन. सो वी हैव टू मेंशन नेम ऑफ द राकेश. राकेश डेबिट टू सेल्स, बिकॉज वी डोंट नॉट मेंशन अकाउंट इन फ्रंट ऑफ नेम. सो इट विल बी सिंपल नेम ऑफ राकेश एंड द अमाउंट विल बी 10,000 लिस्टेड प्राइस लेस 10% ट्रेड डिस्काउंट, बिकॉज दिस टाइम वी आर अलाउइंग 10% डिस्काउंट टू राकेश, विच इज ट्रेड डिस्काउंट नॉट कैश डिस्काउंट. सो इन केस ऑफ ट्रेड डिस्काउंट वॉट वी हैव टू डू, वी डायरेक्टली डिडक्ट इट फ्रॉम द वैल्यू. सो 10,000 इंटू 10% ऑफ 100 इज इक्वल टू 1,000. सो द वैल्यू विल बी 9,000. सो हाउ मच वी सोल्ड गुड्स टू राकेश इज 9,000 ऑफ द वैल्यू. क्लियर. नेक्स्ट थिंग इज इश्यू ए चेक टू सिंह एंड कंपनी इन सेटलमेंट ऑफ हिज गुड. इन अर्लियर एंट्री वी परचेज टिम्बर फ्रॉम सिंह एंड कंपनी इन सेटलमेंट इन ए वैल्यू ऑफ 18,000, बट वी आर नाउ सेटलिंग हिज अकाउंट बाय पेइंग ओनली 17,500. सो इट मीन्स वी आर रिसीविंग अ 500 डिस्काउंट फ्रॉम सिंह एंड कंपनी. सो वी आर पेइंग टू सिंह एंड कंपनी. सिंह एंड कंपनी अकाउंट डेबिट टू, बिकॉज वी आर इश्यूड ए चेक, वी आर नॉट पेइंग कैश. वॉट वी आर डूइंग, वी आर पेइंग थ्रू चेक. सो एंट्री विल बी टू बैंक अकाउंट टू डिस्काउंट डिस्काउंट रिसीव्ड. Account received account and the amount will be, because Singh and Company stand 18,000 in our books. We purchase goods worth 18,000 from Singh and Company and we need to pay 18,000 to Singh and Company. But how much we paying 17,500 and we received a discount of 500. So in case of when we are paying Singh and Company, the amount should be 18,000 and the entry will be Singh and Company to bank or to cash 18,000. But we are receiving a discount of 500 from Singh and Company, so we have to pay less amount to the Singh and Company. How much we are paying? Only 17,500. So the remaining will be discount for us. We are receiving discount from Singh and Company. Next entry is received from Rakesh in full and final settlement 8,750. As we seen, we sold goods for 9,000 to Rakesh. Now he is settling his account by paying 8,750. So it means we are allowing a discount of 250 to Rakesh. So we are receiving cash, because nothing is mentioned that we are receiving check or cash. So what we will do, we will take cash account debit. How much we received? 8,750 to राकेश, एंड राकेश स्टैंड्स फॉर 9,000 इन आवर बुक्स बिकॉज वी सोल्ड गुड्स ऑफ 9,000 टू राकेश एंड ही सेंट ओनली 8,750 इन फुल सेटलमेंट, सो रिमेनिंग 250 विल बी डिस्काउंट फॉर राकेश एंड द एंट्री विल बी डिस्काउंट अलाउड अकाउंट डेबिट, सो एंट्री विल बी कैश अकाउंट डेबिट, डिस्काउंट अलाउड अकाउंट डेबिट टू राकेश बिकॉज वी आर रिसीविंग लेस अमाउंट फ्रॉम राकेश इन फुल सेटलमेंट ऑफ हिज अकाउंट, सो द रिमेनिंग अमाउंट विल बी गो टू द डिस्काउंट अलाउड. और नेक्स्ट एंट्री इज पेड फीस टू लॉयर, सो बिकॉज वी आर नॉट पेइंग लॉयर मंथली सैलरी और ईयरली सैलरी, वी नीड टू पे समटाइम्स ओनली टू लॉयर वेन एवर वी हैव सम लीगल ऑब्लिगेशंस, सो वी विल टेक वेजिस अकाउंट डेबिट टू बिकॉज वी आर पेइंग कैश अकाउंट 15,000, 15,000. Whenever we pay it on daily basis, then that time we debit wages instead of salary. And because we don't hire lawyer on the basis of monthly salary on that, we paid that on the basis of hearing. Whenever there is a hearing, we pay them for that hearing. So we will debit wages account instead of salary account. Next thing is issue a check for rent of February, which is 5,000. So we paid rent account debit. We paid through check, so we will debit bank account instead of cash account. Amount will be 5,000. Hope you are trying generalizing the entry because practice only can make you good in journal entry. Just watching video and trying illustration will not help. You have to do questions from your textbook also. So try to do it by your own. And if you have any query, ask me. Next, we will start our next topic is ledger account. Today we will study only basic things about ledger account. What is a ledger account? After recording the transactions in journal, they are transferred to the relevant account in ledger. And when we record a transaction in journal, we know that we call it generalizing or maybe recording. But whenever we are recording in ledger, we called it posting because we are posting journal entries from journal to ledger. It is a book which contain in the summarized and classified form a permanent record of all transaction. It records all the transaction and it summarized the transaction because we have many transactions of cash, like we are paying salary in cash, we are paying wages in cash, we are paying rent in the cash, we are purchasing machinery through the cash. So how much cash, if we want to check how much cash inflow or outflow from the firm, we need to make an account of cash. On one side we will take inflow, other side we will take outflow. So it is a summarized form of account. A summarized and classified form of accounts. It is a permanent record for all the transactions. Few are the features of the ledger account is, ledger is a master record of all accounts of business. Ledger is a master record which record all the accounts of the business, whether it is cash account, whether it is bank account, whatever account it is, ledger record all the accounts. It is prepared from journal. You can prepare it only through the journal entry. So as I told, journal is the basic thing for accountancy. It start from the journal, then go to the ledger, then go to the trial balance. So for making the ledger account, we have to generalize the entries. Without generalization, it is not possible to post them in ledger account. So next thing is ledger account show the current balance of all account. Ledger account show current balance in all account. Whatever balance we have at that time, it show that. Because in journal entry, you can see only inflow and outflow, and you have to see all the entries, whether it is 100, whether it is 200, but in case of ledger account it is easy to check what entries, because it is specifically mentioned all entries of cash in cash account, all entries of purchase in purchase account, all entries of sale in sale account, all entries of wages in wages account. So it is an summarized or classified form. Next thing is trial balance and final account are prepared from the ledger account. That we know that trial balance is prepared by the ledger account and final account is prepared by trial balance. So for preparing an financial accounting or final account, we have to be prepare trial balance, but for trial balance we have to prepare ledger account. So ledger account is the basic point, basic starting point for the trial balance or preparation of final account. Next thing is format of the ledger account. As we studied about journal account that have five column format, in case of ledger account we have eight column format. First thing is date particular, then it is journal folio, the entry number in journal. Next thing is amount, next thing is date, next thing is particular, JF and amount. So I will post two entries to let you know how to be posting. First, we need to mention here cash account. So we are preparing the ledger account of cash account. First entry is purchase account debit to cash account. It means we purchase goods. So ₹1,000. So entry will be purchase account debit to cash 1,000. Amount will be 1,000. 1,000. Next thing is sold goods for cash 1,000. Entry will be cash account debit to sales. Clear? Amount will be 1,000 and 1,000. So we purchased goods. In case of purchase goods, the cash we having outflow of cash, and in case of sale of goods we having inflow of cash. So and how we post entry in ledger account, we have cash account to sales. So here we post entry for to, here we post entry for buy. When we have cash account debit to sales, it means here is cash account and to sales, so we will post here to sales. Amount will be 1,000, and in case of cash is itself in credit, so what we will do, we will use buy here, buy purchase account to cash. So this term will go here, buy purchase account 1,000. So you can, for making a ledger account, you can try by little this. In case of we have entry on to, we will post here. In case of we have entry on buy, we will post here. After this, you need to summarize the account. Both side have the balance of 1,000. This is for how to post. Let I change amount of the sale. The sale amount will be 10,000. Then the entry for sale will go 10,000 and the balance will go 10,000. Now the balance is here 10,000. We need to calculate the remaining amount that we have balance in cash account. This is the side with the to is inflow of cash, and the side with buy is outflow of cash. So the balance is 10,000 on whichever side have highest balance, we need to mention that balance below. Here, so cash sale have highest balance of 10,000, wherever purchase have only 1,000. So we will take 10,000 as our final balance. So the difference will be 9,000 on this side, and this will be go like by balance sheet. And next year when we need to brought it up, the entry will be to balance BD 9,000. It is an closing entry which is on 31st March, and it is an opening entry which is on 1st April. So this is basically a general format for ledger account. We will discuss it in our next class.